Ah, the humble garbage disposal. It gobbles up your food scraps and they magically disappear? Of course not. In fact, most of them end up right here. Getting here is quite the journey. Good idea to use a garbage disposal when you can.
Yeah,
definitely a good thing.
If the wastewater treatment plant that your material eventually ends up at has anaerobic digesters with beneficial use of biogas.
Wait, what? Let's start at the beginning.
So there's a number of different garbage disposals. They're much more quiet than they used to be. Yeah, exactly.
I don't really see any blades.
Right. So what there is a grinder ring. And it works a lot like a cheese grater.
And it's not that sharp.
No.
Like, I'm not going to cut my finger on this.
Most likely you won't. This is the part that's doing the work.
Oh, okay.
All right. So there's a motor with a shaft. The shaft will cause this to spin, and these lugs will break up the larger parts.
So basically, everything's got to be small enough
to pass through here.
Yeah. So it's getting chopped up pretty tiny.
Yes.
Food comes in here, chopped up through here,
right.
Goes out through there,
right.
And out into
right.
the wider world.
Yeah.
Next, it enters a municipal sewer system. Here in Boston, that means it's now the responsibility of the Boston Water and Sewer Commission.
So each home has what we call a lateral. It's basically a discharge pipe from your wastewater plumbing facilities to our system.
What's coming out of a typical home in a lateral?
Toilets, showers, sinks, any sort of plumbing fixture you can find.
They all get mixed up and they come out one pipe to you.
Yep.
Okay. So, a lateral meets up with a sewer main, and then gravity moves it all down the system?
Correct. Sometimes smaller pipes will link up with larger pipes. There might be more of a slope, so the gravity will work better, but nothing fancy, really. It travels where it needs to go.
So this is it, the Deer Island Treatment
Plant.
The
whole thing, here it is.
It collects wastewater from 43 metropolitan Boston area communities, 2.3 million people, about 34% of the population of the state of Massachusetts. We collect all the wastewater in deep rock tunnels, and we pump it up 80 to 150 feet to get it into the treatment plant, and then it flows by gravity through the rest of the treatment processes.
On average, the wastewater moves through these gargantuan pipes at about 2 feet per second, fast enough to keep all the solid material from settling to the bottom and clogging up the pipes. The flow is regulated in part by enormous pumps that draw the water up to the top of the facility when it first arrives.
You can actually see the pumps. If we stop pumping, it's going to back up into people's homes and businesses, and then it's going to flood out those businesses.
Once it's pumped, it is now slowed down so that the solid material does settle.
We'll collect that as residuals or sludge, and we'll treat that.
So you got this sludge. It's collected. What do you do with the sludge?
So it comes off of the primary clarifiers at really, really dilute amounts. So we have to thicken it.
For that, they turn to Sir Isaac Newton's old friend, gravity, letting materials continue to settle to the bottom in large, aptly named gravity thickeners until it's about the consistency of a frappuccino. The excess water, now relatively free of solids, is pumped away. More on that in a moment. As for the sludge, it's on to the next phase.
These digesters are 140 feet tall, 90 feet wide. They hold 3 million gallons of concentrated sludge. We're talking about 25 days that sludge will stay in these digesters.
And in these man-made stomachs, the digesting is done by microbes, lovingly raised right here at Deer Island.
We're a large bug factory. We cultivate microbes to actually feed off of those dissolved organics. They grow, they replicate, and then they die off, and we collect their bodies. So the sludge that you're seeing is not really what you're expelling from your body. It's actually bacterial bodies that we grew that fed off of the material that's in the wastewater.
And just like in a real stomach, one byproduct of all this digesting, gas.
We want to make sure that we destroy as much of the material as possible, get the use of the biogas for green energy, and then the remaining solids that you can't destroy, we pump that through two 14-inch lines that send it directly to the pellet plant 7 miles away from us.
Wow.
Convert that to a fertilizer and beneficially use that product because there's a lot of nitrogen and phosphorus remaining in that material.
With the solids all taken care of, the final step is to treat the water, which is done in disinfection basins. The tool of choice here is sodium hypochlorite, aka household bleach.
three times more concentrated than what you buy
so
in a bottle.
So bleach.
Serious. And we use about 5,000 gallons of it every single day. But that will get rid of any remaining pathogens.
Yeah.
The last thing that we do is we introduce a chemical known as sodium bisulfite. And that's to get rid of the chlorine, because the chlorine could actually be more toxic than some of the other pathogens
right.
that are there. And then it's free to go into the outfall and then discharge into Massachusetts Bay.
And so ends the epic journey from solid food down your sink to sewer, to sludge, to the sea.
Well, there you have it, folks. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you are curious for more, check out one of these recent episodes. Our thanks to Emerson College for always keeping us curious. I'm Edgar B. Hardwick III. You stay curious out there.